Settled in beautifully up there. Drew really nicely in barrier 8. He'll come out of 5, I think it is. We've done everything we can to have him right. He went out to Bow Desert on Anzac Day, had a good gallop with the Vows, pulled up super from that. So all well, and really looking forward to Sunday. I suppose hopeful that you're going to get a result. Confident that we've done everything in our power to have him cherry ripe.
Emerald Kingdom getting into the clear, coming out after We Own a Smart One. We Own a Smart One. Emerald Kingdom, Alpine Edge, they hit it. Photo, Alpine Edge or Emerald Kingdom, not sure, leave it to the...
Well, what a huge weekend it was for the team. Hello everyone and welcome to the Edmunds Racing TV show. Big Gordon, the champion Alpine Edge, has made his presence known. Of course, the winner of the Archer in thrilling circumstances. And Trent, you were holding the fort here. Great to see him back on home turf with the Archer trophy.
Yeah, he was amazing. And the Lucky Clover guys, the Cupid Syndicate, they certainly partied until the wee hours, and I think Monday was a big struggle for majority of the connections. So huge effort, and as I said earlier in the week, doing the piece for the Turf Club, it was just a plan coming to fruition and getting the job done. Amazing. So yeah, really, really proud of him, and he's back. He's bright as a button. He's had a very, very light week after a couple of big bits of travel. And he'll be back under saddle Monday morning, heading towards, at this stage, the Kingsford Smith.
What a champion. He's pulled up well, and obviously we've mentioned on previous shows, for those that may or may not have seen, but he's still a stallion, but you wouldn't know he's quiet as a mouse, just goes about his business, yep. and you've managed to pull off another feature race. Obviously, you set him for Magic Moons Day. He went bang, won that, and you set him for this one, and he's done it again.
It's not bad, not bad prize money. I think he's $1.1 million or something in the last 4 months, like since the start of January.
Yep.
It's pretty big. So he's just in the zone. Everything's been, apart from the well-documented foot first up, everything's just been smooth sailing. And I wasn't out there, but they say that the track gallop on Tuesday prior to going to Rockhampton was outstanding, and he backed that up, so all good.
Yeah, well, you did give him a fair push to the viewers. Wasn't one of your best bets, but he did make a fair case, as we highlighted at the start of the show, so well done there. Well done to everyone that took $20-odd. Unfortunately, I took 10, but anyway.
Some of the staff blowing up too. So we got him at 11, so he ended up paying 25 or whatever.
I thought 10 was a good price. But well done to the Lucky Clover team. Another huge celebration. That's what racing's all about. And also the Cupid Syndicate, for they obviously own the slot, don't they? So,
yep.
So well done there. Big ownership group celebrating. And I guess before we leave him, the next step for him, Kingsford Smith, is an option?
Yeah, at this stage, I think that's where we will go. 1300 metres, he loves it, likes Eagle Farm, so that's it. Another step up evidently, but while he's in extremely good form, let's have a dig and hopefully we can pull off another upset.
Sure can. All right, well, that was a huge thrill for everyone involved, and it sort of overshadowed another great performance in a way. The Vows running a slashing third, got way back and rattled home, and a huge effort from him in what was his biggest test to date.
Probably nearly should have won, to be fair. Wanted to follow the favourite sort of everywhere it went. Nash went forward on the favourite and sat deep with a little bit of cover. We were giving away 4 lengths at the top of the straight. He run him to a length and a bit, so huge effort. Sectionals, you know, they're there for all to see. It was massive. So he's full steam ahead to the 2,000 metre rough habit next week. And return clash with Kovalika. See how we go. Obviously, it'll improve again to the 2,000. Hopefully, our guy can match motors with him and just find that length that he needs to.
And I guess, you know, the Derby's the natural end progression. So I guess that's the other option beyond that if he runs the trip, though.
Next week tells us a heap more. If he is strong at the end of the 2000, we'd be silly not to keep him going for another fortnight and give him a go.
Yep, good one. All right, and then the other great result over the weekend, Astern Magic showed a real slick turn of foot to overpower them on the poly at the home track. A
couple of flies. opening mouth too wide here. Look, he was actually really good. I think I mentioned, I thought he probably should have won first up.
Yeah.
He was just very green, got a pair further back than we wanted to. Surprised last Saturday how much tactical speed he showed, because he's been, I suppose you'd call him a work in progress. He's very timid, very horse shy. No matter how much gate work we'd done with him or whatever, he's scared when the barriers were opening. So rather than bounding out and going with them, he'd take a backward sort of step and then go. So he's giving away start. And all of his jump outs, he was doing that. And I think even in his first trial at Bow Desert, he'd done similar. But took good improvement. And that first bit of race experience was huge for him. And he won really well. He's a horse with a future. Still pricking the ears and sort of very green, but I think I said previously, once he gets to sort of 1300-1400, you'll see the best of him. Nice patient ride, then bang, he'll use that good turn of acceleration. He's got really nice horse for the future.
Yeah, okay, one to follow as he works through.
And we bred him.
Bred him?
Yes. So
tell the story.
Happy parents, or whatever you want to call us.
Proud mum and dad.
So some owners that had shares in Magic I Am. She was a nice Magic Albert mare who won a Saturday race with Jeff Lloyd up a number of years ago now. She's actually quite well bred. I think she was a three-quarter or a relation to I'm Invincible through her mother. And we kept a hold of her. Dad kept a hold of the stable, kept a hold of her, whatever you want to say.
Yep.
And she's had a couple of foals now. Astern Magic, obviously being by Astern, that was Toby's creative name. Astern Magic, fantastic.
Yeah, that's an award winner, that one.
Wow. anyway, while he's on the road to Coffs Harbour, I can throw it.
That's right. And while the horse is winning.
But anyway, that's a good name if he keeps winning. So, and we've bred another couple of foals out of her that are just sort of coming through now. So it was good for him to win for the mare, and hopefully a little bit further down the track, she can be somewhat commercial rather than race to breed.
Very good. Well, the stable's flying. Another winning week. Huge weekend of results. And let's hope that continues this week. Mimi Lagarde's the headline act in the feature Hollandale Stakes Day, which is rebadged as the Coast to Coast, obviously at the Sunny Coast this year. But before we get to that, let's talk about today's runners heading to Coffs Harbour. Hopefully we can get the show out in time for anyone wanting to take your insights and have an investment. Marone Magic is the first for those runners, for the Queensland Rogues in a Class 1 handicap over the short, sharp trip of 808 metres and trialled well, and you've sort of been waiting for the right race here, haven't you?
Picked this race out nearly a month ago and was hoping that it was dry enough. I was a little bit scared, or we were both a bit scared, when the other day that meeting got called off there. Hello, mate. That meeting got called off there with 83 mils of rain, and it's taken an age to dry. Should come up about a soft six by the time the race is around, so that's perfect. And she's just been a little bit bull at a gate and wanting to get sort of things over and done with when we've stepped out over the 1,000 and the 1,100. So we just thought that 800 metres, the field lacked a little bit of depth, I suppose you could say, and she's drawn soft. They'll go along fast. She should be, I'd like to see her midfield, maybe pair closer than that from that soft barrier, chime in down the middle and get the job done. She's in super form. I thought her last trial, and the reason we're starting her over the 800, that last trial at Bow Desert when Andrew rode her steady and then she whizzed down the middle, that's what we've seen from her at home, where she hasn't produced that on race day yet. So we're hopeful that kicking off down there, taking a little bit of a softer option over the very short course, we can execute properly and get home.
Okay, well, good luck to the Queensland Rogues there.
I'd be disappointed if she got beaten, to be fair.
Yeah, it sounds like fairly, and you've been patient, you waited for this race, and hopefully she can go bang for the Queensland Rogues. Connolly flies the flag in the Archer Park colours. That's the other runner on the program, looking to build on a third on debut last start and up to the 1,000.
He was good on debut, I think it was about 8 weeks ago, over the half mile at Ipswich. Just wanted to duck in under pressure up the straight. I'm not saying he should have won, but I think he probably should have finished a little bit closer. Subsequent to that, the winner of the race came out and won at the midweeks at Eagle Farm. So form was okay. He actually got a little bit crook after that run. We bit the bullet and tipped him out for a week just to let him get his head down and get over it. And he's been warmed up for today with a jump out at Bow Desert last week. So that tightened him right back up, and he's one gallop since has been good. So yet again, he'll be on speed, probably lead them up over the 1,000. And both of those horses there today, can give a pretty solid push to. I'd be disappointed if we were coming home without a result.
Okay.
Fair, yeah.
Yep, fair push there.
And both are short in the market too, so they deservedly are that price.
Yep, they're in there to win it. So well, good luck to Connections there from the Arch Park team. All right, two runners heading the opposite direction up the M1, and it'll be under lights at the end of the day, races. So
late.
You'll need your caffeine or something to keep trainers' hours up.
Mm-hmm.
Mimi in the $160,000 ATC Trophy. She was obviously prominent in a recent trial. And drawn nicely in Barry 2 for Jim Boone.
Yeah, I can't really work the prices out. That's why I'm a horse trainer, not a market setter, I suppose you could say. But anyway, she's going to go around about 20 to 1 at this stage. And I saw horses that they have admittedly had a run that she'd beaten very convincingly last preparation, sort of half her price, which I thought was quite strange. She looks to get conditions to suit, 1,200. Fast speed, soft barrier. If she can jump with as much intent as she did in her trial the other day at Bow Desert, she'll be midfield, maybe a pair worse, and just got to get to the middle. She's a momentum mare. If she gets momentum and can use that turn of foot, she's got an extremely sharp bit of acceleration. So very happy with her. Sunshine Coast will suit, firm track suits, and tick, tick, tick. Can't fault her. She's big odds in my opinion.
Okay. Fair push for another one at a price there with Mimi. And then we turn our attention to last start winner Opacity, who represents in the lucky last the Men Matter race day on July 29 back here at the Turf Club. He's drawn the outside gate, obviously a bit unfortunate, but I guess says something that you guys still are happy to run from there with Mr. Mallion aboard.
Starting from the machinery shed at the mile chute there, that's great. Thank you very much. He's in super form. I suppose if there was a sprinkle of rain about, we would be much more buoyant about his chances and drawing a little bit softer. But beautiful long run. I think you've got about 700 metres until the first turn there. So probably look to roll somewhat forward and try and find a spot. A lot of the time at the Sunshine Coast over the mile, you can do that. If you just persist a little, you can slot in because they bust up a bit and the field sort of strings out. So we'll do that. And off his track work, you say definite yes, he's going super. I just want to see him sort of back on a dry surface because we know how good he is when he gets his toe in and it's rain affected. So he's in super form. I just want him to be what we've seen at home. If he produces that and he's nice and genuine on the firm deck, which his first couple he sort of wasn't, then he's a really good each way chance. And sort of we'll know halfway through the day how firm the track's going to be and whatever. But his word of warning is he's many lengths better on a softer track while you're getting belted here.
Gordon wants to take over the hosting duties, I think.
I said to James and the team that he, like, if it was soft again, you could have something on him because, you know, he's flying. But we'll just see how we go.
Okay.
So each way chance without getting too stupidly confident. Barrier, track conditions.
Yep. Sounds like both good each way chances heading up to the Sunny Coast. And then to round out the weekend, Pretty Az gets back on the grass after a first up fifth on the poly. This is Bow Desert meeting on Saturday.
Drawn soft, big improver. Was outsped on the poly here the other day, which I thought was quite surprising. And once back in behind them was off the bridle, which was, as I said, a little bit surprising. Come back to the inside, last 100 metres was her best and needed the run anyway, so has improved. I think can nearly go out there and win, to be fair. Just be positive from the gates with Sean on, not far from them, and can nearly break her duck.
Okay. Well, another good push for Pretty Az. So Five good chances brings us to the best bets. Toby's on the road, so we'll throw up his on the screen. So you got no visibility of that, but
bugger. Mimi Lagarde for mine. I could have picked one elsewhere or one of the two favourites today, but I just thought she was a good play at 20-1. I thought she's really quite a fair way over the odds.
And the lesson for players from last week could be hold on till race day. You might even get a better price.
This is true.
Although you've given it a push, so it might come.
See, here we go. But yeah, I just think her. She's had a pretty faultless preparation. And that trial at Bowie and subsequent work, spot on. So she didn't have a long time out after Magic Millions Day. A little bit of residual there, and she's a bomb first up on firm decks. So that's me.
Okay, very good. Well, that'll get you well and truly back that's in right, the black if Mimi salutes.
Went about 6 weeks, just winner after winner, and then I didn't tip one for a very long time. On another note, what's your Hollandale tip?
Well,
you haven't looked at the form, have you?
It's hard to go past Arky, isn't it? Yeah. You going to tip against
Arky? No.
I think it's more if we can find a... I mean, a tissue was a really good run in
that
Sydney
was monstrous.
Last night. So
yep.
If anyone's going to cause... Obviously, looks like a horse on
I
the
think
way
that's
up.
The obvious Quinella, myself.
Yep.
Either way. But so, Arky going for a... Three-peat.
Yeah, history.
That'll do me.
Some good horses have won too. Rough Habit, the likes.
Might and Power.
Might. I think anyone won.
Oh, two. Oh, sorry. That was a bit of a faux pas. I thought you meant as in good horses have won it too. Anyway, yeah, sorry.
In two Hollandales. Well, obviously Zaki going for a bit of history there. So it'd be great to see. All right, well, sounds like five good chances over the weekend. Good luck to yourself and have a great weekend, everyone.
Need plenty. Hopefully the momentum continues.